माने रहीम, टुडे द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज सेल वॉल. यू नो स्टूडेंट्स दैट सेल वॉल डिस्कवर्ड बाय द रॉबर्ट हुक इन 1665 व्हेन ही एग्जामिन्ड द कॉर्क अंडर द माइक्रोस्कोप अंडर हिज सेल्फ मेड माइक्रोस्कोप. ही ऑब्जर्व दैट द कॉर्क कंसिस्ट ऑफ द मेनी स्मॉल हनी कॉम्ब लाइक चैम्बर्स सराउंडेड बाय थिक वॉल्स. सो बेसिकली वी कैन से दैट सेल वॉल वॉज डिस्कवर्ड बाय द रॉबर्ट हुक इन 1665. Cell wall is the structural layer surrounding some type of cell outside the cell membrane. It is present in most prokaryotes like in bacteria, also present in algae, fungi and in eukaryotes only in plants. It is absent in animal cells. Now let's discuss the composition of cell wall. The composition of the cell wall depend upon the species. Species mean that which type of species is it, like it either it is bacterial cell or it is fungal cell or it is plant cell. Also depend upon the cell type, which type of cell is this, it is conducting cell or it is supporting cell or which type of cell, and also depend upon the developmental stage of the cell. Like in bacteria, its composition varies. Like in bacteria, it is made up of peptidoglycan and murine or murine, and in fungi it is made up of chitin, and in plants it is usually made up of polysaccharides including cellulose and different waxes and salts etc. But the composition of the plant cell wall depend on its layers. Now we are going to discuss the structure of the plant cell wall. The plant cell wall consists of three layers: primary cell wall, secondary cell wall and middle lamina. Primary cell wall is the cell wall which is present almost in all type of plant cell. It is present in the newly growing cell. During the cell division, the plant cell secrete the primary cell wall by themselves. Primary cell wall is very thin, flexible and extensible layer. It is present inner to the middle lamina. If you look at this diagram, here you can see different number of cells. This is cell 1, cell 2, cell 3, cell 4, cell 5, cell 6 and cell 7. Now you can see here that primary cell wall is present here. This is primary cell wall, then here is secondary cell wall, then cell membrane. But outermost is the middle lamina. Look at this diagram clearly. The outermost layer is the middle lamina. Then after middle lamina, primary cell wall is present. After primary cell wall, secondary cell wall is present. And then cell membrane or plasma membrane is present. So it is present inner to the middle lamina. Mean middle lamina is the first layer, which is between the adjacent cells. The blue marker here shows the position of the middle lamina, outer layer of the every cell. And then after the middle lamina, the layer is called primary cell wall. So primary cell wall is present inner to the middle lamina. The primary cell wall is made up of cellulose microfibrils which run in a crisscross arrangement in the matrix of the hemicellulose and pectin. The function of the primary cell wall is usually to give the strength to the newly growing cells. After primary cell wall, there is another cell wall which is called secondary cell wall. Secondary cell wall is the thick layer. This type of cell wall is not found in all cells. It is found usually in the sclerenchyma cells and those cells which reach their growth. Mean that the primary cell wall is very tough and rigid. It does not allow further growth. So therefore, in the plant cell, those cells which are not going further, they complete their growth. In those cells, the secondary cell wall is present. Secondary cell wall is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose, lignin, inorganic salts and waxes. Position of the secondary cell wall is, you can see it is present between the cell membrane and primary cell wall. Mean that between the primary cell wall and the cell membrane, secondary cell wall is present. Then the last one is the middle lamina. Middle lamina is the name indicate. middle lamella. Middle lamella means that it is the layer, outermost layer of the cell, but it is present between the adjacent plant cells. Adjacent plant cells, look at this, this is cell 1 and this is cell 2. Between the cell 1 and cell 2, this blue layer shows the middle lamella. What is the function of middle lamella? Middle lamella basically glues the cells together. The middle lamella, the main function of the middle lamella is to join the neighboring cells together. It is made up of calcium, jelly-like calcium and magnesium salts and pectin. So it means that the middle lamella is one of the most important layer because it binds the cells together. So these are the main layers of the cell wall.